Dear students, today's video lesson topic for first year Satavahana University students is on reading books. This essay is written by Virginia Woolf. It is taken from the second common reader written by Virginia Woolf. So let us know about the author. Woolf is recognized as one of the most innovative writers of the 20th century. Her famous novels are Mrs. Dalloway, To the Lighthouse, and Orlando. She experimented with a fictional technique called stream of consciousness technique. So let me explain what is stream of consciousness technique. This is a mode of narration that involves the continuous flow of a character's mental process. Ampashaya Naveen is the first person to use stream of consciousness technique in Telugu literature in his novel Ampashaya. The movie Ampashaya is also available on YouTube. If you watch the movie, you can understand the stream of consciousness technique very well. So let us see the next slide. On reading books essay text, copied it from your textbook, and I have given in second slide, third slide, and fourth slide. You read the text carefully and thoroughly, read it twice or thrice. Okay, in the first paragraph there are some important lines for your annotation. Do not dictate your author, try to become him, be his fellow worker and accomplice. So in a second paragraph she mentioned the famous novelist Daniel Defoe, Jane Austen and Thomas Hardy. So read the text carefully. In third last paragraphs she discussed the importance of biographies, autobiographies and memoirs, and I also have given pictures of autobiography, biography, memoirs, and the cover page of the famous novels Pride and Prejudice, Daniel Defoe's Robinson Crusoe, Thomas Hardy's The Mayor of Cassavetes. So here I can't explain every line in the text, so I made some bullet points, some important points. Let us see what Woolf suggested. Woolf suggestions on how to read a book. Books have classes. We see different genres in literature: fiction, autobiography, biographies, poetry, memoirs. There are many kinds of books in literature. They have classes. So when you want to read, we should separate them and take right thing from the book. Read with an open mind. When you start reading a book, read with an open mind. Do not read it with your opinion or with prejudice. Next important point is banish all preconceptions. If you have a preconceived idea on a book, it's not good. Okay, so we should banish all preconceptions on book before reading. Do not dictate your author, try to become him, be his fellow worker and accomplice. Here essayist Woolf tells us not to dictate your author. She suggests us, do not tell your author what he must do, try to understand the author and be his fellow worker. She also urges us that should not say, why would the character do that? Why this innocent or good character was killed by the author? Should not question him. We should respect the author's choice and try to understand why did he write that. If you don't criticize first, if you criticize, you don't get the fullest possible value from the book. If you criticize in the beginning, the reader do not get the complete value from the book or novel. So she gives an advice to the readers that don't criticize in the beginning before reading the whole book. Open your mind as widely as possible. Reader has to open his mind widely. Then only he can see subtle things in the book. The twist and turns can be understood very well by the reader. The more, she also says that the more you involve, the more you get from the book. She moves on to say that she compares 32 chapters of a novel to a big building. You know, big building has so many rooms and it is made up of built with bricks. Here words are like bricks. You can feel bricks physically, but you can't feel the words in a book physically. So she says that reading is more complicated process than seeing. Learn to read by trying to write. The quickest way to understand the elements of a novel is to write. To understand the novelist well, Wolf suggests us not to read, but to write our experiences. For this, she gives an advice us to recall some events in our life that may be comic or tragic. Then you come to know that some impressions must be controlled, some must be emphasized. So when you try to, before reading, when you try to write like an author, the events from your life, you know that you can understand the author's hard work, how difficult it is to reconstruct your experience, how difficult it is to put in the form of words. Turn from your blurred pages to the opening pages of some great novelists: Daniel Defoe, Jane Austen, Thomas Hardy. All these three belong to a different world. So let us see about the great novelist Daniel Defoe. Daniel Defoe's famous work is Robinson Crusoe. Jane Austen's famous work is Pride and Prejudice. Thomas Hardy's The Mayor of Casterbridge. So let me give a brief description of Robinson Crusoe's story. Robinson Crusoe set sail from England on a sea voyage. His ship is wrecked in a storm. All the people die except Robinson in the ship. Robinson manages to survive for many years on an island. He rescues a man from cannibals and makes him his slave. He names the boy Friday. So this is a story of Robinson Crusoe. So Defoe's themes are travel narratives, mainly travel narratives and adventure. You see ocean, open air in his novels. when you see Jane Austen Pride and Prejudice, there is drawing room conversations, her world is domestic world. She draws her characters from real life. The main theme of her novels is matrimony, love, parties, weddings, dances, drawing room conversations are main ingredients of her novels. So we see Daniel Defoe and Jane Austen both are completely different. Okay. But if open air and adventure mean everything to Defoe, they mean nothing to Jane Austen. So their worlds are different. What is important to Defoe is not at all important to Jane Austen. Let's see Thomas Hardy, the mayor of Castle Beach. See here the other side of the mind, the darker side. Hardy associated with the pessimism, fate, nature and tragedy. His imaginative county is Wessex, like Malgudi by Narayan. Okay, so we have seen three famous novelists and their works. They have created a world specific to their world view. They have their own world. To read a novel is a difficult and complex art. You must be capable not only of great fineness of perception, but capable of great boldness of imagination. So she suggests here that reader must have the great quality, that is imagination. Biographies, memoirs and autobiographies are all important and consider them as works of art. Biographies, autobiographies, memoirs are also to be considered as work of art. Do not ignore them. Read them in a different way. She says that some people refuse to read biographies and autobiographies because they are not works of art. But they are all, she suggests that biographies and autobiographies are equally important as fiction, are equally important as fiction and poetry. We must remain readers. As readers, we have our own importance and responsibilities. So we can remain good readers without being labeled as a critic. As readers, we have our own importance and responsibilities. So with this, I finish on reading books lesson. Thank you for watching this